On stage, the musicians had already set up their gear. Now they were sitting at a small table in a corner drinking coffee, except for the leader, Lasse Tidal, who was standing at the bar with a beer in his hand. He nodded casually as I approached. "A good morning to you," he said in an imitation of standard Norwegian, before reverting to his sedate Bergensian. "Out to lubricate the works, eh? Never miss an opportunity. And your lungs are in good shape?" "I stick to ballads now, you know. But I still have some puff in my chops. You'll see." Lasse Tidal was well into his 60s, with a high forehead and thick grey hair over his ears. Some of the power behind his puff clearly came from the midriff area, which had increased in girth, presumably to accommodate powerful bellows. "I was wondering, a younger colleague of yours, Halvard Hagenes, do you know anything about him?"
"Halvard, oh yes. Talented young tenor player once."
He scanned the room.
"Sometimes he drops in, but I can't see him today. Not yet, anyway. He drives a taxi to make ends meet. It's never been easy to survive as a jazz musician, but nowadays it's nigh on impossible, unless you're among the absolute top performers. And he isn't. Not the way the market is in Norway, anyway. Have you got a job for him, perhaps?"
"Afraid not. I just wanted to ask him a question."
"Tore Lude and Rida Rongved over there have worked with him on some trio gigs. I can introduce you to them in the first interval, if you like."
"We're about to start now."
"Where would you place him on the local scene?"
"Oh, you know, there are several good tenor players in the district. Serbstadt's still going strong. The Hystad brothers. Olaf Dahle. But Hagenes is no slouch.